In 1966, a high school senior from Ottawa, Kansas, showed promise as a cinematographer with a knack for capturing the personalities of people and a sense of place.
First, while we're downtown, I'd like to try on a new coat.
By the way, I could use a new sport jacket.
Shortly after, Tom Speer began his full-time career as a television photographer in Nebraska at such varied places as the University of Nebraska Medical Center, Cinegraphics.
Taste of Johnny Time popcorn, can't get enough, gotta have some more.
You harvest grain in the fall.
And Nebraska Educational Television.
Dateline Nebraska, now in its fifth season, continues to bring...
In 1979, Nebraska's loss was Seattle's gain when Tom moved west to join the team at KCTS-9, Seattle's public television station.
In those days at KCTS, there was a public affairs unit, and then we actually created a cultural affairs unit.
Straight down. There's some pretty big waves in there.
He was just excited about everything. It was kind of his attitude, I thought, was contagious. And he could do anything, and he would do anything. And he said, let's go do it.
Along with giving audiences an intimate look at events around town.
I work for Safeway. I'm a meat wrapper.
Tom continued to highlight places and people and the issues they faced.
You know, when somebody's here, you think they're gonna be here. Especially a sister, because we were younger than, you know. So I thought we had plenty of time.
16-year-old Opal Charmaine Mills is one of possibly 40 victims murdered by the Green River Killer.
See, planes take off and land toward the wind.
Tom photographed the experiments of Bill Nye, the science guy, and the streets of New York with Nick Stellino.
How are you? This is a pretty unique situation, you know. It's Nick Stellino's dinner party, but it's not.
The heat of the Southwest Desert. And the cold at the top of Mount Rainier.
We worked a lot together. And so I traped him up over hill and dale. I mean, that was really rough sometimes because I'd make him carry his camera up steep slopes that were soggy snow, and he'd have to, he was such a good sport about that show. It was always an adventure to work with Tom. You already knew you were gonna laugh, but you knew you might get mad too. He didn't suffer fools easily, but yet when he was involved in the project, you can't imagine anyone better. I think he had the steadiest hand of anybody in town.
Tom also brought his talents and the ability to carry all his equipment at once to the look and feel of travel around the world, photographing a number of programs that would become staples of the public television travel show genre.
You know, he just sort of helped us invent the style. People really trust him, and it's like he can coax real life out of people in a very special way, and it's just amazing, you know, the quality of work that he has done all the way along.
Tom shoots, edits, and produces most of the stories that you see on CityStream and a lot of the work that you see on Seattle Channel in general, so we said this is the perfect person to host our holiday special. And here is Tom Speer right now. Hi, Tom.
Hi, Marcy.
Guess what, Tom? You are going to host our holiday special.
So we're here at a place that you almost never will find, Tom.
The Seattle Channel was more than fortunate to land Tom. His friendly enthusiasm and keen eye helped make the channel a go-to resource for Seattle arts and culture and local public and community affairs.
Having somebody who is not afraid to just jump in and do it, it was a little bit of the Tom Speer, Tom Sawyer, hey, let's all get together and, you know, put on a show.
Tom has done more than support and mentor co-workers, build community bridges, and innovate and enhance the countless number of programs that have crossed his lens. From somehow covering an event with three cameras all by himself, or earning the nickname, the Human Tripod, for his steady handheld work, One could always rely on Tom to get the shot.
He's a guy who has just huge passion, I think, about what he does. And the city has been richer for it. The arts community has been richer for it. And certainly I have working with him. He's the hardest working guy in show business. They say that with James Brown, but I think it's Tom Speer. I really do.
Though he is now driving off into the sunset, Tom Speer can be sure his television family and friends will continually look to him to help point the way and inspire us to put on a show.